Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at hybridization of heteroatoms. So this is for organic chemistry. We use primarily carbon, and so we call other atoms like oxygen and nitrogen heteroatoms. So we're going to cover just some common hybridizations for those atoms that you're likely to see. So I'll start with ether. So this is diethyl ether. When you hear the word ether, this is what people are talking about. And there's an internal oxygen atom. So remember that internal atoms tend to hybridize to accommodate bonding patterns. So I've drawn a line angle formula here. This oxygen has on it two bonds and two lone pairs of electrons to get to a total of four groups around it, would be that a lone pair or an atom, and a total of eight electrons. So this oxygen atom has four groups around it. It is sp3 hybridized. So remember, if we put the superscript on the one, there's one s and three p orbitals that combine to make four sp3 hybrid orbitals. One plus three is equal to four, and that is the number of groups around that central oxygen atom. So there's a lone pair here, a bond to carbon there, a lone pair here, and then another bond to carbon there. So the hybridization of that internal oxygen atom is sp3. The bond angle is going to be a little bit less than 109.5. So those lone pairs of electrons are going to sort of squish in the bonds a little bit. They're not shared between atoms, and so they're kind of taking up more space. It's about 104.5, but less than 109.5 is fine. And the shape of the molecule is bent. So we're talking about the bond to bond shape, right? So you've got an oxygen in the middle and you have two groups coming off of it, and this shape is going to be bent, okay? The hybridization is sp3. The electron geometry is tetrahedral because there are four groups, but the shape, the molecular shape, is bent. And this will be true when we see an internal oxygen, so an oxygen between two atoms where it has a single bond to each one. Okay, so now let's take a look at nitrogen. Nitrogen has a couple of different hybridizations that it can accommodate. I'm going to use wedges and dashes again because this is not a planar molecule. So remember that a wedge is sticking out at you and a dash is going back. And so it allows me to draw something in 3D even if I'm on a two-dimensional surface by using wedges and dashes. So this nitrogen also has four groups around it, right? It has three bonds, one, two, three hydrogens around it. So here's one, two, and three. And then it also has a lone pair of electrons. And hybrid orbitals can be used for bonding, or they can house lone pairs of electrons, okay? So with the four groups around it, this is going to be sp3 hybridized. The molecular shape of this is trigonal pyramidal. So it looks kind of like a pyramid, right? That lone pair is pushing those H's down. And so they're sort of standing up like a pyramid there. So that's the molecular shape of the molecule. And then the bond angle here, again, is less than 109.5. It's a little bigger than with oxygen because there's only one lone pair instead of two. We can also see nitrogen with a double bond. So I'm going to draw out a molecule here where we've got a double bonded nitrogen, and then let's maybe just make this a CH3. And so there's a lone pair of electrons here, and I'm just going to put them like in an orbital there. So we can see here that we have three groups around the nitrogen. It has a total of eight electrons around it, but there's this carbon here is one group, this carbon here is the second group, and then it has a lone pair of electrons. So this is an sp2 hybridized nitrogen atom. The shape of this is also bent because you just have three atoms that are in a row there, carbon one, nitrogen, carbon two, and they're not linear because of that lone pair. That lone pair is pushing those two groups. The furthest apart I can get three things is about 120 degrees apart. This is probably slightly less than 120 degrees because of that lone pair. It's occupying a little bit more space and cranking that bond angle a little bit. But again, it's going to be about there. Okay, so I'm going to draw this molecule again, and we're going to look at bonding types. So we'll look at the central nitrogen, and then we'll just sort of list what's coming off of it like we have in some of the past videos. So we are going to be looking this guy, okay? So first, let's see if we can do our hybridizations, right? This carbon on the end here on the left-hand side, it has three H's and one nitrogen for a total of four groups around it, so it is sp3 hybridized. The central nitrogen has three groups around it, so the carbon on the left, the carbon on the right, and the lone pair of electrons, so that three tells me it's sp2 hybridized. And then the carbon on the right has an H, an H, and an N for, again, three groups, and it's sp2 hybridized. Every atom here has a full octet, but the bonding pattern and the inherent valence of the atom are going to give different orientations for the way that those electrons are organized. So let's look at the different types of bonds we observe here. That nitrogen has two sigma bonds. So we can say sigma from the nitrogen, which is sp2 hybridized, to the carbon on the left, which is sp3 hybridized. That's one sigma bond. It has another sigma bond from the nitrogen, which is sp2 hybridized, to the carbon on the right, which is sp2 hybridized also. Then it has a pi bond. That's what makes for the double bond between nitrogen and carbon on the right. So it's a nitrogen 2p overlapping with the carbon 2p. Remember, in organic chemistry, pi bonds occur between unhybridized p orbitals. It's a 2p because this is the two valence shell. It's the second shells where our valence electrons are. And then lastly, it has a lone pair of electrons, and those electrons are in an sp2 hybrid orbital. So remember that hybrid orbitals can be used for bonding, but also they can accommodate lone pairs of electrons. So this has been a look at hybridization in heteroatoms for organic chemistry. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.